In this overview for administrators, we'll show you the highlights of configuring a tax reporting application. Now that you've created a tax application, the next step in the implementation process is to configure the application. We'll cover adding metadata, entering tax and exchange rates, and configuring tax automation. If you haven't created an application yet, you can view a short video on the Oracle Help Center that covers this task. Let's start by reviewing the provided dimensions. They are account, period, consolidation, data source, currency, intercompany, entity, movement, multi-gap, jurisdiction, scenario, years, and view. This set of dimensions handles the tax provision process. Each dimension is preceded with members to allow for flexible application configuration. Let's focus on the dimensions for which you'll need to add members related to your organization. First, add currency and jurisdiction dimension members in which the entity operates. Then, add the legal entities. Since a base currency needs to be assigned to each entity, and a national domicile needs to be associated with each base entity. Add the national and regional jurisdictions that your company operates in to the jurisdiction dimension. As a best practice, only add currency and jurisdiction members that will be associated to entities. You'll want to add your legal entity hierarchy into the entity dimension. The account dimension will store the trial balance or book balances and the tax account data for calculation of a tax provision or country-by-country report. You'll need to add book accounts based on your trial balance chart of accounts, tax accounts required for permanent and temporary differences, R&D and other credits, net operating losses, and additional provision items. You can tag book accounts for use in the tax account roll forward form and the country by country report. In the dimension editor, select the book account, then select the attribute values tab, expand TAR and CBCR to view columns of the report. Assigning attributes here pulls data from the account into the respective tax account roll forward or country by country report column. For the scenario dimension, the actual member is for the current year-to-date provision. You can add forecast and plan members or other members as needed. In the multi-gap dimension, additional reporting standard members can be added to report by other bases of accounting, such as International Financial Reporting Standards. For additional information on working with metadata in Oracle Tax Reporting Cloud, you can view a video by the same name on Oracle's Help Center. When you've updated your metadata, next set up tax rates, consolidated tax rates, and exchange rates. The tax rates form contains the national and regional tax and apportionment rates needed by the system to compute the national and regional provision for a specific entity. You enter tax rates for base entities only, not parents. You can enter both national and regional rates if the entity supports regional jurisdictions. And apportionment rates can be entered here as well. You can set whether a region is active here. If set to active, the system will calculate a provision for that region or state or province. The consolidated tax rate is the tax rate in which the parent entity is domiciled, and the starting rate for the effective tax rate reconciliation in the organization's consolidated financial statements. Currency exchange rates can be loaded by file or entered here. Best practice here is to run the compute rates business rule after modifying exchange rates. Tax automation is among the key processes that provide data for the core tax calculation. It represents the links between the book data and tax data. The tax automation process allows you to calculate permanent and temporary differences directly from the source financial data in the general ledgers or from the financial consolidation system. The automation of permanent and temporary differences streamlines your tax provision process. Using tax automation, the system starts the current provision process by copying the net income before tax amount from the entity's income statement into the net income before tax entry of the current provision. This ensures that the starting point for the current provision equals the legal entity's financial statement pre-tax income. You set tax automation by account using a source and target account paradigm. You can use the no entity member to create a global rule, and you can define entity-specific rules. Let's review the columns of the tax automation page. By default, global automation rules are enabled for all entities. You can use the disabled column to disable a global rule for some entities. For the logic column, select pull, move, or squeeze. The pull option pulls a number from the income statement account, multiplies by a factor, and assigns it to a tax account. This is generally used for permanent differences. Move captures the movement or change in balance in balance sheet accounts, multiplies by a factor, and assigns it to a tax account. This is generally used for temporary differences. Squeeze calculates by determining the difference between the desired ending balance and current activity, including the beginning balance. Enter a percentage in the percentage column. In the source account column, select the originating account. In the target movement column, define the movement member where you want to move the data. If no value is selected, the default value is used. The default is automated. The other adjustments, automated and equity automated options, do not impact current year, but do impact the deferred tax calculation. You use the return to accrual form to true up the accounting records as a result of the differences between provision amounts and the tax return. Use this form to select the year and period where the adjustment from the return should be applied. You can apply the adjustments from more than one return year to the same target year. For example, adjustments from the 2015 and 2016 returns can both be applied to the FY17 year. Once the configuration is complete, you can load your data and begin work in the application. Many of the configuration tasks covered in this video are available using the SmartView interface. In this overview, we showed you the highlights of configuring a tax reporting application. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.